Welcome to this tutorial on the Perlin Noise Node in Gaea. In this tutorial, we'll explore the various properties and options available within the Perlin Noise Node to help you understand how to create intricate and realistic procedural landscapes. To find the Perlin Node, we'll look in our toolbox under Primitives. And there it is, Perlin. I'm going to click and drag that onto my graph. And here we are with the default Perlin Node. That is pretty cool already. Let's go over all the properties though. I'm going to turn these all down to zero so we can see what each one of them does. If you've been doing any kind of landscape modeling over the years, this tool definitely reminds me of the old Bryce 3D days, or even an old Vue. I use this node quite a bit in my landscapes. The scale property controls the size of the noise pattern. Increasing the scale will create larger features in your landscape, while decreasing it will result in finer details. As we slide the scale across, we're basically just enlarging each one of those hills. You can see as they begin to grow. As we get to 100%, it's just going to be a big flat square. We're zoomed in that close. So I like to think of the scale slider more as a zoom slider than scale. As you can see, we're really just zooming right in to a random hill. We'll bring that back to 0%. Next up is octaves. The octave setting determines the level of detail and complexity in the noise pattern. Higher octaves produce more intricate landscapes with finer details, while lower octaves create smoother, more generalized terrain. And you can see how we're already starting to get a lot of detail starting to pop out. That's looking pretty cool already. And we can ramp this all the way up to 14. Wow. Let's take a look at the noise options. There's three of them under the Perlin node. The first one is FBM, which stands for Fractal Brownian Motion. This noise type is a classic fractal pattern, commonly used for generating natural-looking terrains with smooth transitions between features. The next option we have is Rigid. Rigid noise produces sharp, jagged peaks and valleys, often resembling rugged mountainous terrain. Whoa, that is pretty weird looking, but you can definitely see this is really rigid. The next option we have is billowy. Billowy noises create soft, undulating shapes, ideal for generating rolling hills or cloud-like formations. It's got some neat rollings here going on, curves. I could see this being a lot of little foothills somewhere on some landscape. Pretty cool. We're going to change back to FBM. Our next property setting is Seed. The Seed property allows you to generate different variations of the same noise pattern by changing the random seed value. Experimenting with different seeds can yield diverse and unique landscapes. I'll usually scroll around and look for something that I like. This one's kind of interesting. Could be a good starting base. And finally, we have the Warp tool. Warping introduces distortions to the noise pattern, adding realism and complexity to your terrain. We have three options to choose from. None disables warp, leaving the noise pattern unaffected. Next up, we have a Simple. Simple applies a basic warp effect to the noise pattern, introducing gentle distortions. And finally, we have Complex. Complex utilizes more advanced warping techniques to create intricate and realistic variations in the terrain. Complex, however, only works with the warp octaves. So let's take a better look at the warp frequency. That is really neat looking. The warp frequency controls the frequency of the distortions applied to the noise pattern. Higher frequencies results in more frequent and pronounced distortions. You can see as we ramp this value up in percent, those distortions become really pronounced. Huh, this almost looks like a rose petal right here. That is pretty cool. The warp amplitude determines the strength or intensity of the distortions. Increasing the amplitude will produce more pronounced warping effects, while decreasing it will create subtler distortions. And now let's take a look at the last tab, complex. Warp octaves will not work if you don't have complex selected. It just doesn't work in simple. So we gotta make sure we're in the complex mode here. What is warp octaves? Similar to the octaves property in Perlin Node, warp octaves determines the level of detail and complexity in the warping effect. Look at the detail it starts to add as we ramp this up. And as it slides down, it gets pretty mushy. Alright, we've got one more tab here, the transform. Yet another powerful tool. The scale X and scale Y properties allow you to adjust the horizontal and vertical scaling of the noise pattern independently. This can be useful for creating terrain features with different aspect ratios or adjusting the overall shape of your landscape. So let's go ahead and revert back to the defaults by clicking defaults right here. I'm going to click yes to this. Wow, I almost forgot what the original default looked like. When I start out my projects, I usually like to be within the 50% to 60% range in the scale. I'm going to set this to 56. This maybe about 4 or 5. Let's try 4. I'm going to leave my setting at FBM for now. Make sure we're on complex here. Let's amp this up to about 15 or 16. Wow, that is crazy looking. Change the amplitude though. Let's dial that down because that's really high. There we go, that looks a lot more normal now. And we'll add about 5 octaves for this. We lost a bit of the detail there. I do want to bring this out just a little bit more, maybe 0.7. There we go, this looks like a pretty good pattern. I'm gonna play around with the seed just a little bit. See if we can't get anything else just a little more interesting. Oh, wait, I saw something that I liked. That one's kind of interesting, but that mountain part gets cut off. There we go. I like this one. Let's play around a little bit more with this. Let's change it to rigid. Oh, yeah. Now this, I'm liking this one. And there you have it, my friends. We've covered the ins and outs of the Perlin Noise Node in Gaea, exploring its various properties and options to help you create stunning procedural landscapes. Remember, mastering these tools takes practice, so don't be afraid to experiment and push the boundaries of your creativity. If you found this tutorial helpful, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more content like this. And if you have any other questions or suggestions for future tutorials, feel free to leave them in the comments below. All right, my friends, thank you for watching, and happy terraforming!